Hey all, I've decided to go out for a walk in the snowy park just to enjoy it and soak it all in. This morning I was meant to go up to Colchester to get involved with the Is It Worth It bus. But looking at the weather and the road conditions, it's not worth it. So this bus that was going to go to Clacton-on-Sea is now going back to Luton to park up just for safety. But it's done fantastic work. And what I want to talk about is Brexit is now very clearly to everyone falling apart because the weight of its own contradictions are just making it yawn and creak and fall. Take, for example, trade. Outside the customs union, all these free trade deals that we could strike alone, well, the Treasury's own analysis says that it's not worth it, it would cost us money. And then this is even seconded by the Rand Corporation, an American think tank, saying if the UK wanted to do a trade deal with the US, its best bet would be to do it in conjunction with the EU. Then let's move on to regulations. Oh, we have to unshackle ourselves from all of these regulations to set British business free. Well, British business has been saying, don't you dare collapse these British European regulations and standards that we've built. The only people that would favour is the American and Chinese corporations that would then undercut us. So Brexit is not even pro-business. Then let's move on to immigration. Oh, we have to control our borders. This freedom of movement is flooding us out. Really? Well, in every single year that you look back, this free movement immigration from the EU has always been less than non-EU immigration, which we have complete national control of. No matter, they say, there are too many immigrants in the country, it is straining our NHS. Oh, really? If you look at immigrant density in areas and correlate that with A&E performance, no correlation whatsoever. But what's the Brexit vote doing? It's encouraging EU immigrants to leave. Specifically, look at all of those EU nurses that have been plugging gaps in our workforce over these years. They're the ones that's leaving, and that is what's putting a strain on our NHS right now. So all of these Brexit arguments, before we even get on to the farce that is Ireland, are all falling apart under the weight of their own contradictions. Over and out.